Hey guys, it's me, Mini Fluffy One, and welcome to Let's Play LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. A 15-year-old game. This game is 15 years old, but the original LEGO Star Wars was the first game that I myself ever played completely on my own. I was like 4 or 5, something like that. But I found this game on Steam. It was on sale, and I was like, well, why not? I don't have anything else to do, so I'm gonna just record this game. So we're gonna start a new game, because I have a different one already started. And we're just gonna jump right into it. The audio of the game's gonna be a little quiet. Actually, I can... Nah, this is appropriate recording volume. I'm really good. We're just gonna jump right into it. Each episode is just gonna be however long the mission is, except for the pod racing level, because that normally takes me like 5 minutes. But here we go. Chapter 1, Negotiations. I'm debating. I'm going to be skipping the chapter intros because of the music on them. I can't, you know, copyright infringement. Gotta avoid that. This game is a timeless classic. And it is still fun today. It holds up surprisingly well. This game is so old, it was came out before split screen in LEGO games was a thing. This was actually, the original LEGO Star Wars was actually the very first LEGO game that Telltale made. Y'all are gonna learn very quickly, I have a unique obsession with collecting every single frickin' stud out there. I'm completely obsessed with money. I just can't not. Any other money out there? Okay, cool. Nice. Cantina band. Give me the blue. Got the blue. Blue has been got. Primary goal achieved. Money, 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 money. My precious. But yeah, so this game is still all kinds of stupid fun today, which is kind of wild. There aren't a lot of games that hold up this well after so much time. It's really hard to pull that kind of thing off. But for this, it does. And I don't mind the fact that the characters don't talk. In fact, I think it's a little weird that they do talk today. I actually prefer the no talking in LEGO games. I just think it's... I like the charm of it. LEGO games are charming. At least the earlier ones had that charm about them where the people wouldn't talk, they would just make grunting noises. I don't know, I just liked it that way. If, you know, Skywalker Saga, LEGO Skywalker Saga is coming out this year, and when I do get it, I'm gonna do a series on it. And it's gonna be awesome, because I love Star Wars a lot. Stupid amounts of love for that franchise. Alright, time to show off and just destroy these losers. He says after immediately taking damage from them in like the first 2 seconds. Hey, stupid! Shoot at me, I dare you. I didn't see them open fire. Oops. I'm gonna be Obi-Wan for a second because Obi-Wan is cool, man. I love Obi-Wan. Obi-Wan is one of my favorite characters. And oh my god, what are you guys doing over there? Stop! Leave me alone, meanies. Stupid pit droid. Never stood a chance. One thing you guys learn quickly is I'm really good at just sucking the money out of each of the levels. Mainly because I'm completely obsessed with it. Oh, man, it's just great. It's great that way. How the heck go... Oh, yeah, it just flat out opens and I miss this one. I believe there's actually a mini-kit canister in here. Thanks for all the moolah! If done correctly, you can usually complete this level with about 80,000. And I'm already almost a true Jedi status, which is awesome. I believe there is a mini kit canister. Nope, there is no mini kit canister in this room. But I'm already at True Jedi, and I haven't even left, you know, the first area. Of course, this level only has two areas in it, and that was kind of stupid on my part. There's one. What's up? Come on, just die so I can get this money! No! Okay, I got some of it. Most of it. I got most of it. But recently I've realized that I've gotten really good at manipulating this game so I can get to areas I shouldn't be able to get into without the free play mode. I guess it's just more awareness of game mechanics, really. But, like, there are certain areas where, like, you know, for example, Jar Jar can jump way higher than all the other characters. It's a way to make him useful because, well, everyone knows Jar Jar that Jar Jar is a complete idiot. Can't do anything. It's a way to make him useful, and I need to grab this mini-kit over here as well. And, like, I'm finding ways to circumvent that. Some of them take a little time, and it can get a little annoying. But I'm just so obsessed with the completion of it all that I don't mind. For the sake of time, I won't be, like, going absolutely insane with that stuff. You know, if it's quick and easy workaround, I'll do it. But this is also going to be a 100%... I'm considering making this a 100% playthrough just so I can, you know, do everything there is to do and honestly have an excuse to continue playing. Because I love this game. I love it a lot. It's, you know, it's a big part of my childhood. Very, very massive part of my childhood. I don't know why I said childhood like childhood. But I did. Now I'm talking in a weird way and I don't understand it. Why is Qui-Gon? Qui-Gon? Hey, Kikone. Thank you. That was a little weird. I just want to collect all the money in the room before I release these droid boys. And also, just for the sake of seeing how much money I can accrue, doing the entire main story, I'm not going to spend any money on like buying characters or anything until I have completed every level. First of all, I know I'm gonna have like well over 1 million studs, and that appeals to me. Well over 1 million studs. Well over 1 million studs. I think Qui-Gon is an underrated... Talk about this for a second. I think Qui-Gon is an underrated Star Wars character. I do. I like Qui-Gon. I think he's cool. It's because he's, you know, only in Phantom Menace, and obviously some little bit of the Clone Wars. I think he's in one episode. He appears as a Force Ghost Anakin. The point is, I like Qui-Gon. And to the story, Qui-Gon is incredibly important, not only because he trained Obi-Wan, but because if he had beat Darth Maul in the Duel of the Fates at the end of Episode 1, things would have, you know, turned out completely differently, because he's the father figure that Anakin needed, and, you know, all that sort of stuff. I wonder what would have happened if he hadn't have died. Where the hell is Droid Boy? Oh, right, I yeeted him. Oops. Droid Boy! Boy, droid? I think this droid is actually... Hey! Doofus, come here. TC-14, why you have to be so stupid? I like the way they waddle along. It's just like the protocol droids in the movies. But anyway. Like, I wonder what would have happened had Qui-Gon lived. I mean, if Qui-Gon lives, one could argue, does Anakin even turn to the dark side? Does he become Darth Vader? Does the Empire happen? I think there's you could logically conclude the answer to be no. And if Disney ever taps into, like, alternate universe stuff, and they did do a, you know, what if Qui-Gon lived sort of thing, and that's the story they go with, I would believe it. It just kind of makes sense, because Qui-Gon would have handled things a lot differently than Obi-Wan did, especially since, at first when Obi-Wan was training him, he was training him out of a promise to Qui-Gon, and not because he actually cared about him. Which, you know, makes a big difference. There's a mini kid up here. If I could, you know, ever... I'm too far to the side. Got it. Cool. And there's a... Well, I screwed that up. I'm gonna get it, don't worry. Feeble droids, you will learn the full power of the dark side. Oh god, Commander. Oof. I oofed him. He's dead. But, I'm looking... No. Move this boy first, because he's the big boy. This is a series that I am really, really excited about, and I might just, you know, blaze on through it, to be honest. Now, I know I can get back up there, because I did it last time I was playing. Then you just gotta jump around and get this. Yeah. Up there is an R2 terminal, and obviously we don't have R2 yet. Do the droids walk around, like, legit? Power up. Hello there. Or, I'm sorry, I don't know why.
Hello there.
That makes more sense. Sup? Y'all are dumb. Stupid, dumb idiots. I'm not gonna use the power up over there yet. Or as one of my friends calls it, Rainbow Sparkle Time. Which, to be honest, is a pretty hilarious name for it. So maybe I should just call it Rainbow Sparkle Time. Alright. Droidicas, prepare to feel my wrath. You are losers. I'm way too good at deflected stuff, bro. You are weak sauce. I don't know what the point of that is. But I... Oh yeah, wait, this is a, yeah, that's what that one is. Then you flip this, and it becomes a thing. These break, you collect the money from them breaking. Yeah, as I was saying, I just think it would be really cool, you know, if they dove into that kind of stuff. Because there's a lot of untapped potential there. And as much as Disney Star Wars makes me nervous, especially given how the sequel went, I would still be excited to see them tap into this alternate universe kind of stuff. Oh wait, I can't pick up coins on a vehicle? Really? That's dumb. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, wait, I flipped that switch too early. LOL! I also could have flipped the other switch to suck the droidicas over here. So before I jump up there... Gonna need to flip this switch again. Once it, allows me to. There it is. I wait for it to cycle back. Because there's a mini kit canister over there. Almost screwed it up again. Whoopsies. Cool. Now to build these boys. Because why not? Man, I got like 82,000? Jesus Christ. You know, Qui-Gon, you could have taken the other direction. Come at me. Ah! I'm a little too focused on being fancy. That was dumb. Gotta kill these boyos, because they dumb boyos. This first mission has gone really well, and surprisingly... I mean, I know my commentary is better than it was when I first started. That is a given. It's actually been over a year since I began, which is crazy. Wow, it has been over a year since I began. Well, dang. Not uploading consistently, but my first upload... That those are privated now, but... Actually, they're deleted now. They don't exist on the channel. But those were in March. I can't believe it's been a year. Alright, but anyway, that is mission completed. 85,410. I'm 50,000 past True Jedi. I don't think there was much more I could have gotten out of this in the first go-round. Alright. TC-14 unlocked. That was an incredibly successful first level. And now we're gonna have like 86,410. Or was it 140 or 110? I can't freaking remember, man. It was 410! Yay! Oh, going after those super mini kits is gonna be an annoyance. But that is 3 out of 5 possible. 2 out of 5 possible. Alright, anyway, we're gonna go back to the cantina. And I'm not saving over game one. That would have made me cry. But yeah, so anyway, that is gonna do it for this episode of LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. If you liked it, do be sure to hit a like, and if you're new here, subscribe and hit that bell button for notifications on all my new videos. Hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.